Happy birthday to you.
In 1894, Cotting School first opened in the basement of St. Andrew's Parish House in Boston.
In 1895, Cotting was at 6 Turner Street in Boston's Back Bay. There were only 2 small classrooms with 26 students. Today, it is a residential street with family homes.
'96, 424 Newberry Street, Boston. The school moved to Newberry Street. They rented the building until they had enough money to build a new school.
In 1911, Cotting School was located at 241 St. Botolph Street in Boston. This new building held 150 students.
In 1987, Cotting moved to Concord Avenue, where it is now.
So here we go. Drivers, start your engines.
The first students to arrive in 1894 were brought to school in horse-drawn carriages, with each one-way trip taking between 45 and 60 minutes. In 1929, Gray Line Tours buses were rented to transport students. The area of service went as far north as Medford, Malden, and Revere, as far west as Brookline, and as far south as Roxbury and Dorchester. For many years, transportation was the school's largest expense because it was free to students and dependent on donations and the generosity of others. Today, the school has students from 74 cities and towns in Massachusetts and southern New Hampshire.
Hey, Gianna.
Gigi, look.
Hi. This is the first 15 years.
1893, Cotting School opens.
Action.
In 1895, school grew from 7 to 15 students. In 1896, school grew to 36 students.
1902, school is on St. Street.
Action.
1911, school grew up to 100 students.
Action.
School has free tuition, hot lunch, and transportation. 1912, new outdoor classrooms added.
1926, larger buildings are added.
The beginning of Cotting School students have been playing sports.
The first record of the organized sports is this photograph of the 1927 girls' basketball team.
Men's basketball has been continually played since the late 20s. The women's team stopped at some point after the 1930s and were not started up again until the late 1970s.
The facilities were different at the school in Boston. Most of the sports were played outside on the blacktop. If you were playing baseball and you hit the ball too hard, you might break a window in the building next door. The basketball court was only a half court with an 8-foot hoop.
This all changed when the school moved to Lexington. Students were now able to enjoy more outdoor areas to play sports and a larger basketball court with 10-foot hoops.
Hey Michael, what's that book you're reading?
It's about the history of Cotting School. It's pretty interesting.
What kind of stuff is in it?
It has lots of cool old photos and interesting facts.
What kind of facts?
Well, like when the school opened in 1893, it was called the Industrial School for Crippled and Deformed Children.
What does that even mean?
I think industrial has to do with work, like working in a factory.
They made the students work in a factory. That seems so wrong.
Maybe it was like when they go to workshop. They were teaching them how to do different jobs.
Okay, but what about the words crippled and deformed? I don't think those are positive words.
Crippled sometimes means a person who can't walk or move properly. It can also mean severely damaged.
That's right, Lily. The prefix D means not, so I guess deformed means not formed correctly.
I'm formed correctly. Look, two hands, two legs, one head. Looks pretty correct to me.
I don't worry, Alex.
Maybe that's why they took the word deformed out the name in 1948. They changed it to just the Industrial School for Crippled Children.
I still don't think they should have used the word crippled.
I agree. I don't think that's a nice word.
The people who started the school weren't trying to be mean by calling it that. Cotting was the first school in the U.S. for kids with challenges. That's just what they called it back in the old days.
I'm glad. They don't call it that anymore. When did they take the name out of it?
Well, 1974, the name was changed to Cotting School for the Handicapped Children. It was actually one of the students who helped get rid of the name.
Oh. That's pretty cool. But how did they do that?
This girl named Mary Fitzgerald spent 2 years bugging the people in charge to change the name. They called it Cotting after one of the directors who really helped advance the school.
I'm glad they took crippled out. But is the word handicapped much really much better?
Yeah, I don't want to be called handicapped. It makes people think that you can't do stuff, and I can do a lot of stuff.
So true, Aaron. You and I are really good artists and are good at sports.
I'm so good at stuff.
When did they get rid of the word handicap?
That happened in 1986 when the school moved from Boston to here, to Lexington.
So that's when they started calling it just Cotting School.
I'm glad that they don't use any of those terms today. People should not be labeled.
Unless they want to label us with words like wonderful, fantastic, awesome, or totally cool.
I like the rainbow.
Me too.
School opens in the fall of 1894. It donated space. Andrew's Parish House.
Fond here, Mary Perry, but school's first teacher and superintendent for 7 students.
Now there are 110 students who go to college.
It was a full day of academics, a noon meal, and a horse-drawn carriage. A transfer student.
Class, write map, sign in to the
712:30.
The campus was 14 acres. Students had more room to play games outside.
It was big and bright.
Unaccessible to all.
Many students
at Cotting
had
cerebral
palsy and spina bifida.
Many at Cotting School
have
cerebral palsy.
Physical and occupational therapy became common in 1950. In the early 1900s, there were helpers from Miss Colby School for gymnastics who donated their time to massaging and muscle training.
OT helps you with writing and fine motor skills like typing. Sometimes we like playing board games.
PT helps with physical activities like walking. It helps your legs and arms.
The medical department helps you if you're sick, need certain medications for or if you need help with the bathroom or feeding.
The dental clinic. The dentist cleans your teeth and gives you fluoride.
The vision clinic. The eye doctor checks your vision.
Vision services. See, these people may help make sure you can see properly with class activities.
Communication therapy.
Everybody uses CT a little bit differently because they're all working on different things.
This is Ms. Working's office, and we use zones of regulation by ourselves in our class to help with our feelings in there.
Raidanam nas tetonanam. Jagat honam ras raidanam nas.
Today, the Work Skills Program offers a variety of on-campus and pre-vocational opportunities as part of an integrated curriculum.
Experience-based learning programs, Project Bridges, offers students opportunities to examine and explore work environments in the community and prepare students for life after Cotting.
For girls in the 1940s and 50s, cooking, sewing, and needlework were common classes built into their curriculum. Dressmaking became a popular activity in the 1970s.
As typewriters and computers began allowing students who were developers were now able to communicate using a program developed by MIT.
The success of students opens eyes to the potential of computer science as a teaching aid as well as a viable career opportunity for physically disabled students.
When did you learn?
Helping students become more independent has always been a goal of the school's co-founders, which continues today.
Today, Cotting has Project Bridges at the Hope House for us to become more independent.
In 1899, the co-founders wrote printing, Sloyd, dressmaking, millinery, and sewing. Have been taught also elementary clay modeling.
Student-produced handicrafts led to student employment opportunities upon graduation in 1930.
From 1900 minus 1950 basket, weaving activities, setting type, printing, typing into the linotype machine, shoe buffing, woodworking, and office training were all activities students could participate in to maximize their goal of independence, self-reliance, and self-support.
Happy birthday, Cotting!
Happy birthday, Cotting!
We work at stores, schools, community centers, and rail stations and nursing homes.
We have jobs opening packages, putting books in ABC order, greeting people, working with kids, stocking dining rooms, and restocking medical exams rooms. Working is fun and exciting and awesome.
Carding, Bag and Box, and Pog didn't have history, but now we do. We have Mr. Manners as our history teacher, and he's a great history teacher. He's been teaching us about the women's suffrage and the civil rights movement, and he has regards a fair game of Uno. Good luck, Mr. Meredith. I hope you do Uno with the next history class and the next generation of the next new year.
We got to live together.
Cotting has food services. Lots of kids like the macaroni and cheese.
Hate me, you know me, and then you can figure out the bag I'm in. I have everyday people. Yeah, yeah.
I like to go to Home Depot with Miss Piscopo, Miss Maskin, Delaney, Sylvia, Lexi, Tyler, Andrew.
Thank you, Milligram Star.
Cotting has therapists too. I work with Miss Plant, Miss Rooney, and Miss Singer.
For anybody in the audience who's got a birthday today, happy birthday to you!